Everybody, it's JJ here. It's Monday, December 7th, 2020. Quick update on the stimulus check situation. Quick answer for those in a rush. Will we get a stimulus check? Will the American people get a handout in the form of another $1,200 or similar stimulus check like we did back at the beginning of the year? Will we get one before the end of the year? The short answer is no. So there we go. But there are some other things in the work as far as assistance, and I just put out another Patreon video for those of you that are following me on Patreon. Just go to the following link. You'll see it on the screen right now, and you can follow me over there and support me over there, and we get into a discussion of the broader aspects of what's going to be happening here in the next few months. We're almost at the point where we're going to see big things happening. But a $1,200 stimulus check, not likely to happen. So back to this article. All right, now I should say, when I say that there's going to be no $1,200 stimulus check, I should make it clear that it can still happen. Right now the answer is no. As of right now, it's not a yes, or it's not a definite that there will be a $1,200 stimulus check or any check at all as far as checks that were handed out, you know, like the beginning of the year. But there is a package that is being implemented, but so far stimulus checks are not going to be part of that. Now today, December 7th, Monday, there's a bipartisan $908 billion stimulus package, which is essentially a compromise between the two parties. And this new plan is expected to include a boost of $300 a week in federal unemployment payments. And as expected, and I told you this was going to happen, a renewed freeze on evictions, funding for state and local aid, and money for small businesses. And it also includes funding for transportation and for, let's call it, immune system enhancing injections. And I'll read it right out of the article for you. It does not include another round of stimulus checks like those approved in the early days of the pandemic. And at that time, it included $1,200 for individuals, $2,400 for married couples, and an additional $500 for each dependent. Now, take a look at some of the desperate people in this country right now. This was going to be a handout of a $250 grocery card. Take a listen to this report here.
In Miami today, this was the line for a chance to nab a $250 grocery gift card handed out by the city to pass another big relief bill now.
The risk of overdoing it is less than the risk of underdoing it.
Okay, so you can see that this despotism from the American people is continuing, and we've reported on it here many, many times. People waiting for hours in food lines to get sometimes a very small amount of food handed out. People are desperate. And unless something huge doesn't happen, and a $1,200 stimulus check is not the answer to this problem, we need a mega, mega transformation of this entire economic and financial system. All right? Now, I expect some very eye-opening things to start happening this month. And I think it's going to be much bigger than just what we talked about at the beginning of this video. It's much bigger than just extending the evictions or handing out more stimulus checks. All right, and we're going to start seeing things unfold here, in my opinion, in the next few weeks. And within the next 6 months, and this is a huge prediction. I've never predicted this in my, three-plus years of being on putting out videos. I've never predicted something like this. In the next 6 months, we're going to see a major transformation of this economic system, right? And I don't want people to be complacent. I still want you to prepare, and I want to stress that this is not something that's going to be immediately recognizable as something good. At the beginning, it could look very scary, right? So we could see corporations fail, banks. I expect to see things happening with the banking system and banks. But people are getting so, so desperate right now. Let's take a look at a couple tweets here. @_SEAB tweeted out the following. Just to be clear, I'm looking for a handout and I want the government to hand out $2,000 a month retroactive to March. So going back, 9 months, this person wants $2,000 a month. That would be a check of about, $18,000. All right, sounds good. It sounds like that would be a solution, but it's actually not. Just handing out checks is not going to reconstruct or transform the entire economic financial system. What would happen if you handed out that amount of money is you would just see, first of all, massive inflation, because you would have millions of people with a lot of money to spend, and you would see products and goods and services get gobbled up so quickly that you would see massive, massive price inflation from a consumer standpoint. All right, not good. Especially when the bubbles are already massive. So you would see home prices go up even faster than they're already going up. And you would see especially food, rapid rise in prices for food. You would see, you know, a lot more empty shelves and higher prices and more demand, just to put it into perspective for you, right? So unless you get the asset bubbles under control, stimulus checks being handed out, even $2,000 a month retroactive, are not going to fix the problem. We need to stop the system and the people that are keeping these asset prices inflated. The Fed, they are terrified of deflation. Terrified of deflation. Ask yourself that question. Why is the Fed afraid to let prices correct to fair market value? Right? There's a reason, and I don't want to be the thought king here. I don't want to tell you exactly, you know, what I think it is. I think I know what it is, but ask yourself, why are they afraid of deflation? Right? This economic illusion is put out there, and it's real dangerous if you don't recognize what's going on. Also, somebody followed up to that tweet with the following. This is out of at Wild Yoon Likely, and I still want a rent/mortgage moratorium and debt forgiveness. All right, so let's wrap it up, folks. Hope you have a good Monday and a good rest of the week. We might see you later today with another report, but definitely at least another report by Tuesday. And don't forget, if you're a Patreon, go over to Patreon to the following link, and we'll see you over there. Until next time, thanks for watching, everybody. Stay safe, stay well, stay prepared. Bye for now. Peace.